真佛宗西雅图雷藏寺同修准提佛母本尊法，恭迎真佛宗创办人无上法王根本传承上师圣尊莲生活佛，师母莲香上师仁波切，众人虔诚合掌，唱诵莲花童子心咒。 师尊好，师母好，顶礼坛城，一拜根本传承上师及十方三世一切诸佛，Om Ah Om。 仁波切及诸位上师上座，请教授师法师上座，请讲师助教同门善信大德就座。同修准提佛母本尊法开示，观想真佛宗传承，南无大日如来，南无佛焰佛母。 南无阿弥陀佛，南无莲花童子，南无莲生活佛，观想师尊与诸佛菩萨注定放光加持，持莲花童子心咒七遍， Om Guru Lian Sheng Siddhi Hum. 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 做四无量观，观相右手边有父系亲人，左手边有母系亲人，后方有恩人施展，前方有冤亲在住，四周有六道众生团团围绕，同修密法，共成佛道。做金行手印。念清净咒及安土地真言 Om Siu Li Siu Li Maha Siu Li Siu Siu Li Soha Om Siu Do Li Siu Do Li Siu Mo Li Siu Mo Li Soha Om Hwa Zhi Na Dang He He Hum Nam Mo San Man Do Mo De Lan Om Du Lu Du Lu De Wei Soha 念招请咒 Om Ah Hum Soha Om Ah Hum Soha Om Ah Hum Soha 众弟子一心奉请南无宏观赦免金刚上师莲生活佛南无宏观赦免金刚上师莲生活佛南无宏观赦免金刚上师莲生活佛同修主尊南无准提佛母同修主尊南无准提佛母同修主尊南无准提佛母南无中央毗卢遮那佛南无东方阿处佛南无西方阿弥陀佛南无南方宝生佛南无北方不空成就佛南无本师释迦牟尼佛南无药师佛南无无极瑶池金木大天尊南无地藏王菩萨南无莲花童子南无观世音菩萨南无文殊师利菩萨南无弥勒菩萨南无金刚萨埵南无莲华生大士金刚护法空行诸天神众十方三世一切佛一切菩萨摩诃萨南无摩诃波耶波罗蜜多做观想大礼拜一拜根本传承上师及十方三世一切诸佛 Om 啊 Hum 观想顶礼回天心善印二拜诸菩萨 Om 啊 Hum 观想顶礼回天心善印三拜诸护法金刚 Om 啊 Hum 观想顶礼回天心善印四平等于其受大曼达供养首节供养首印观想供品变化无量无边布满虚空宇宙上供根本传承上师历代传承祖师祖尊准提佛母十方三世一切佛一切菩萨摩诃萨中共龙天护法空行下师六道众生念供养赞及供养咒须弥四周并日月化诸珍宝供养佛种种珍奇诸功德消业速速正菩提唵萨瓦达他嘎达依达姆咕噜那那面扎那康里里耶达雅密做四归观想观想根本传承上师历代传承祖师一切诸佛法宝身宝结合起来成为大白光给自己灌顶念四皈依咒南无古鲁贝南无布达耶南无达摩耶南无僧伽耶南无古鲁贝南无布达耶南无达摩耶南无僧伽耶南无古鲁贝南无布达耶南无达摩耶南无僧伽耶做披甲护身手结金刚合掌手印念金刚手菩萨真言七遍 Om Bodhi Lian-Sheng 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 念高王观世音经，奉请八大菩萨，南无观世音菩萨摩诃萨，南无弥勒菩萨摩诃萨，南无虚空藏菩萨摩诃萨，南无普贤菩萨摩诃萨，南无金刚手菩萨摩诃萨，南无妙吉祥菩萨摩诃萨，南无除盖障菩萨摩诃萨，南无地藏王菩萨摩诃萨，南无诸尊菩萨摩诃萨，观世音菩萨，南无佛，南无法，南无身，佛国有缘，佛法相应，常乐我净，有缘佛法。南无摩诃波耶波罗蜜是大神咒，南无摩诃波耶波罗蜜是大明咒，南无摩诃波耶波罗蜜是无上咒，南无摩诃波耶波罗蜜是无等等咒。南无净光秘密佛，法藏佛，狮子吼神主幽王佛，佛告须弥灯王佛，法护佛，金刚藏狮子游戏佛，宝胜佛，神通佛，药师琉璃光王佛，普光功德山王佛，善助功德宝王佛，过去七佛，未来显皆千佛，千五百佛，万五千佛，五百花圣佛，百亿金刚藏佛，定光佛，六方六佛名号，东方宝光月殿月庙尊音王佛，南方树根花王佛，西方照王神通烟花王佛，北方月殿清净佛，上方五宿精进保守佛，下方善济月英王佛，无量诸佛，多宝佛，释迦牟尼佛，弥勒佛，阿修佛，弥陀佛，中央一切众生在佛世界中者，行住于地上即在虚空中，此由于一切众生各领安稳休息，昼夜修持，心常求诵此经，能灭生死苦，消除诸毒害。南无大明观世音，光明观世音，高明观世音，开明观世音，药王菩萨，药上菩萨，文殊师利菩萨，普贤菩萨，虚空藏菩萨，地藏王菩萨，清凉宝山亿万菩萨，普光王如来化身菩萨，念念诵此经，七佛世尊，即说昼夜。你佛地，求佛地，佛地，陀罗尼地，尼诃那地，毗尼尼地，摩诃伽地，遮尼城地，娑哈。你佛你佛地，求佛求佛地，陀罗尼地，尼诃那地，毗尼尼地，摩诃伽地，遮尼城地，娑哈。你佛你佛地，求佛求佛地，陀罗尼地，尼诃那地，毗尼尼地，摩诃伽地，遮尼城地，娑哈。尼婆尼婆地，求诃求诃地，陀罗尼地，尼诃那地，毗尼尼地，摩诃伽地，遮尼城地，娑哈。尼婆尼婆地，求诃求诃地，陀罗尼地，尼诃那地，毗尼尼地，摩诃伽地，遮尼城地，娑哈。尼婆尼婆地，求诃求诃地，陀罗尼地，尼诃那地，毗尼尼地，摩诃伽地，遮尼城地，娑哈。尼婆尼婆地，求诃求诃地，陀罗尼地，尼诃那地，毗尼尼地，摩诃伽地，遮尼城地，娑哈。十方观世音，一切诸菩萨，誓愿救众生，称名悉解脱。若有智慧者，殷勤为解说。但是有因缘，读诵口不错，诵经满千遍，念念心不绝。火焰不能伤，刀兵力摧折。慧路生欢喜，死者变成佛。莫言此事虚，诸佛不忘说。高王观世音，能救诸苦厄。临危急难中，死者变成佛。诸佛欲不虚，是故应顶礼。此诵满千遍，众罪皆消灭。后福坚信者，专攻受持经。愿以此功德，普及于一切。诵满一千遍，众罪皆消灭。高王观世音经中，念七遍往生咒：南无阿弥陀佛耶，哆他伽哆耶，哆地耶他，阿弥尼陀佛比，阿弥尼陀悉檀婆比，阿弥尼陀毗迦难帝，阿弥尼陀毗迦难哆，伽弥利伽伽那，遮哆伽利娑哈。南无阿弥陀佛耶，哆他伽哆耶，哆地耶他，阿弥尼陀佛比。阿弥尼陀悉檀婆比，阿弥尼陀毗迦难帝，阿弥尼陀毗迦难哆，伽弥利伽伽那，遮哆伽利娑哈。 Namo Amitabhaya Dodhagyadoye Dodayata Aminitabhavi Aminitabhavi Aminitabhigyanante Aminitabhigyananto Gyamini Kekyana Chittokyani Soha Namo Amitabhaya Dodhagyadoye Dodayata Aminitabhavi Aminitabhavi Aminitabhigyanante Aminitabhigyananto Gyamini Kekyana Chittokyani Soha Namo Amitabhaya Dodhagyadoye Dodayata Aminitabhavi Aminitabhavi Aminitabhigyanante Aminitabhigyananto Gyamini Kekyana Chittokyani Soha Namo Amitabhaya Dodhagyadoye Dodayata Aminitabhavi Aminitabhavi Aminitabhigyanante Aminitabhigyananto Gyamini Kekyana Chittokyani Soha Namo Amitabhaya Dodhagyadoye Dodayata Aminitabhavi Aminitabhavi Aminitabhigyanante Aminitabhigyananto Gyamini Kekyana Chittokyani Soha
从巴特玛古玛拉穆德 visualize our lineage guru, Solemnous Living Buddha Lian-Sheng, empower us with the three lights. Set Padma Kumara Mantra 21 times.
Om Guru Lian Sheng Siddhi Hum. 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 Om Guru Lian Sheng Siddhi Hum.
首节准提佛母根本印。Form Cundi Buddha Mother Basic Mudra. First, empty your mind. We said the Sunyata Mantra.
Om Sobhava Sutta Sava Dhamma Sobhava Sutto Hang. Om Sobhava Sutta Sava Dhamma Sobhava Sutto Hang. Om Sobhava Sutta Sava Dhamma Sobhava Sutto Hang.
Visualize a blue moon disk in the sky. At its center, there's a white six-syllable zun radiating light yellow light. The six-syllable inside the moon disk revolves and transforms into Mahajundi Buddha Mother, whose body is light yellow. Wearing a crown adorned with the image of a Buddha, has three eyes and 18 arms. She wears white celestial garment and her arms are adorned with ornaments. From the right side, clockwise, the wish-fulfilling banner, lotus, bathing vase, lasso, its book wheel, conch, precious vase, the wisdom chest, headdress, the basic mudra, virtue scepter, hook, axe, heavenly fruit, mala beads, the wisdom sword, and the fearless mudra. The root mudra, together with the root mudra, there are 18 arms. visualize the Mahajundi Buddha Mother wearing the beautiful crown sitting above and on top of us. Visualize the third eye of Mahajundi Buddha Mother, whose brow point shines a bright light upon our third eye, onto our apex to purify our whole body. Visualize the third eye of Cundi Buddha Mother shine light upon our third eye so that our body is crystal clear and pure. Visualize our heart chakra to become a lotus blossom, at the center a mundus, at its center the Zun Sit Syllable. Visualize the Sit Syllable radiating light to invoke Cundi Buddha Mother to enter onto our central channel, to be seated on top of the lotus, and with the snap of the fingers we become Cundi Buddha Mother and inseparable and indistinguishable from her. Recite Cundi Buddha Mother mantra 108 times. First, perform mala visualization. Recite the mantra.
Om Jali Juli Jun Ti Soha. 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 Om Jani Juni Jun Ti So Ha. Om Jani Juni Jun Ti So Ha. Om Jani Juni Jun Ti So Ha. Jani Juni Jun Ti So Ha. Om 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 Jani Juni Jun Ti So Ha. 做九节佛风,
perform nine cycle Buddha breathing, enter into samadhi.
加持八大本尊心咒及念佛
Om Amitavase Om Mani Paini Tom
Om Panamo Ling Toling Soha Om Hahaha Vaisamoye Soha Om Jali Juli Junti Soha Om Jambhala Chanung Chanaye Soha Om Ahom Beza Guru Pema Siddhi Hom Se Om Ahom Guru Pe Ahusa Samaha Lian Sheng Siddhi Hom Deyata Om Bekatsiya Bekatsiya Maha Bekatsiya Naja Samo Katehe Soha Namo 36万亿 Tomin Tonghao Ami Tofo Namo 36万亿 Tomin Tonghao Ami Tofo Namo 36万亿 Tomin Tonghao Ami Tofo
持除瘟疫度母心咒 Recite the mantra of Tarao dispels epidemics 21 times.
Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha Om dara tu dara tu ra namo hara hara hum hara so ha 请大家起念，请佛注释起愿文。
Listen to the Buddha to stay in Sahamo. I pay homage and supplicate His Holiness the Virtuous and Marvelous Tantrika, all Buddhas of the Ten Directions, compassionate Bodhisattvas, Herukas, Dhammapalas, and Dakinis, protectors of Dharma. my body, the nights are long, the three poisons are proliferating. My body and soul are stricken, tumbling in the misery of perpetual rebirth. With great compassion, His Holiness came to this world to salve its deluded ones. Three jewels emanate wondrous light to provide refuge for all. All four unit beings, humans, and devas delight on His Vajra body. For the bestowal of teachings, vows, precepts, empowerments, and attainments. We disciples of Buddha plead that you stay in this hour to turn the Dharma wheel to benefit and give happiness to multitudes of sentient beings. We said the mantra of longevity Buddha 108 times and dedicate the merits to the health and longevity of our lineage Sri Guru.
Om Amarori Juvandiye Soha. 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 Om Amarori Juwantiye 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 Soha.
Hui xiang. Yuan wo ding hui su yuan ming.
Dedication. I pray that my samadhi and wisdom will swiftly reach perfection and luminosity. I pray that I will quickly attain my third eye, the majestic Yidam and the great Pure Land. I pray that together with all beings we attain Buddhahood. May all uphold the Buddha, ascended and robbed utmost bliss, repaying fourfold generosities from above, aiding those in the three realms below. Upon seeing the Buddha, may we transcend life and death. Like the Buddha, may we live with awe. To Buddha disciples wholeheartedly pray to Namo Cundi Buddha Mother to please supply your unexcelled marvelous power to protect our lineage of Guru from all calamities, bestows great health, peace, longevity, self-mastery, to continually stay in samsara, to turn the Dharma wheel with great bliss and spontaneous activities. Inviting His Holiness Living Buddha Lian-Sheng to perform the overall merit dedication. With my palms folded in reverence, I take refuge in the Society Sutra precepts and homage to the Mother of Seven Kodis Buddha Mahajundi. Homage to Cundi Buddha Mother. We pray to Cundi Buddha Mother to bless all Bhartu spirits to be reborn into the pure Buddha lands. We pray to Cundi Buddha Mother by your 18 arms and the Dharma implements in your 18 arms to bless so that our karma can be eradicated, that the pandemic can be eradicated, that the coronavirus can be eradicated. We pray to Cundi Buddha Mother by your pure heart, shine light everywhere. May we have pure mind and attain luminosity. Please bless the spiritual cultivators' qi channels and light drops. Our body, speech and mind can be all purified. Please bestow resources and wisdom. Methods and wisdom can be attained perfectly. The development stage and perfection stage can be executed together. We pray to Maha Cundi Buddha Mother to please bless all beings with palms folded in reference to ethic refuge in the Society Sutra of Precepts and homage to the Mother of Seven Qualities Buddhas, Maha Cundi. Cundi Buddha Mother, gods in heavens, gods on earth, may be far from all calamities, may all calamities abandon us, let all disasters turn into dust. May all of our prayers be granted. May all hindrances, obstructions disappear. May the pandemic disappear. May the coronavirus disappear. May all enemies and enmities disappear.
One!
We say 100 syllable mantra 3 times.
Tathagata peca mami mancha peca bawa maha samaya sato ahum pe om peca sato samaya marupanaya peca sato tenu badicha jato me bawa soto kayu me bawa sopo kayu me bawa anurato me bawa shawa siti me buraya cha shawa gama sutra me jitamu siniyan guru hum
Guru
and all Buddhas, visualize full procession on the ground, release the mudra. Second to all Bodhisattvas, visualize full procession on the ground, release the mudra. Third to all Herukas and Dharma protectors, visualize full procession on the ground, release the mudra. Fourth half bow. Recite completion mantra.
Om bring, om bring, om mari pemi hom. 让我们以最热烈的掌声感谢法王圣尊对生活佛家使徒修圆满吉祥。 请大家先观看由真佛波叶藏所制作的影片。
Now let's watch a video clip produced by the TB Bo Ye.
随缘路福藏，一问一答圆满智，互动就是力量。
Grandmaster is emitting his wisdom, hidden treasures through the question and answer. Your abstract paintings are beautiful, but how can you understand? I understand my own abstract paintings because I know what I'm thinking in my heart. So it's normal that I cannot understand. But Grandmaster, you paint this language of the heart. What are you talking about? So the green circle represents the eyes. What I see, the sound of my heart. And the orange is the journey of spiritual cultivation. And the red is love towards sentient beings. Thank you. Now let's enjoy this painting, the language of the spirits. His Holiness practiced through the Taoism, Mahayana Buddhism, and Theravada Buddhism for the past 50 years. And he has through attainments, and now he exposed all his pith instructions and provided for sentient beings so that they too can understand. So that's the inspiration from this painting. For details, please read Grandmaster's latest book, number 279, Monologues Under Solitary Lamp. So the publication of the combination of the writings and paintings will be circulating soon. Because His Holiness Buddha Dharma is combined with arts and writings. So, in this book, Monologue Under a Solitary Lamp will be available starting September 1st. It's the sounds of His Holiness Heart. There's poetry, paintings, and so we would be able to read Grandmaster's latest book very soon then. The offering of Hatha. Let us now join our palms with reference, and we would like to have the Venerable Lian Yi to present the offering of Hatha on behalf of all of us to our root guru as a symbol of the highest honor. Now let us join our palms with reverence, and together we are inviting His Holiness to bestow the precious Dharma teaching. First, let's pay homage to the lineage gurus. Homage to the Venerable Monk Liaoming. Homage to Master Sakya Zengkong. Homage to His Holiness the 16th Karmapa. And homage to Master Dupten Dorji. Let's pay homage to the three jewels of the altar. Homage to the main deity of the group practice today, Maha Cundi Buddha Mother. Sumo. Anzen Kato, Tuten City. All Dharma Masters, Dharma Educators, Dharma Teachers, Dharma Lecturers, Dharma Assistants, Directors of Temples and Chapters, and all disciples present here and over the internet. How are you? How do you do?
Hola amigo, que quiero mucho. Scoin, y chiva, kimochi, chumi, yapi, brin brin, konbanwa, dacha hao.
Today, watching the TB Boye, the new book Monologue Under a Solitary Lamp, that will be published on September 1st. The book cover looks like an abstract painting. But abstract painting is will not let people understand, and that's why it's called abstract. A painter can paint something realistic. So when we paint a human being, it would look like that person. When you paint a corner of a house, like the drum there, and the frames, and then you paint it as is, then when you see it immediately, you know it's a drum. That's a realistic painting. And then an impressionistic painting. So your impression about certain things, and then you paint it based on that impression, the impression that you have in your brain or in your mind. That's considered the impressionistic painting. And the realistic painting is the ones that's closest to reality. If it is from a little bit more like the impression in the brain, and you paint it. That's called the impressionistic paintings and the abstract paintings. You just take a little bit from the impression, what impression that you have in your mind, just being taken a little piece of it, and you exaggerate it, enlarge it, or shrink it, or change the form. So when we paint a mountain, it doesn't have to be like a mountain. A circle can be a mountain. A triangle can be a mountain. A square too can be a mountain. Or a rectangle can be a mountain too. So what you paint can be called mountains, and that's considered abstract painting. So just now, I said that the eyes without face, only the eyeballs. So that represents your viewpoint. And the lines represent the roads. And the red ones represent spreading the Buddha Dharma to deliver sentient beings. So that could comprise an abstract painting. And we need to have the painter to explain the abstract painting, what they experienced during that time. So anything can be morphed into anything, change the forms. Therefore, I've been painting for so long. Other than techniques, you need to master the techniques, some of the techniques. And basically, what you have to master is the feelings that it evokes. This painting have a feeling? Is there a feel to it? If it gives you a feel, that means it's a good painting. But if you yourself don't feel any feeling, it's very easy, then I just tear it and throw it in the garbage can. There were several times when I did calligraphy, and it was really messy, really bad. So I crumpled it, and yet someone picked it up. You didn't want it, but they picked it, and it turned out to be the most expensive one. So I myself did not have any feeling seeing it, but how come other people have feeling? So that's also a question there. Bian is my painting assistant for a long time. When I'm tearing the paintings, she kept saying no, because she wanted to keep it for herself. Whenever she said don't tear it, then I would tear it. to little pieces, but when she didn't say anything, I just tear it into big pieces. That's all life is about. I learned how to paint at 50. So one painting a day. Even when I have no time, I only have 5 or 10 minutes left, and I can still paint one painting in that time. And if I have no time at all, and no inspiration at all, then I would just do a few calligraphy. That's what I do every day. I will not just waste it. The same thing about my writing books. Sometimes I have inspiration, and I can finish the article very fast in half an hour. When there's no inspiration, I still write. Usually, it takes an hour to finish an article, but it would take me 1.5 hours instead. And I would tumble and write and could not continue, and my brain was about to explode. So in one book, there are some articles that was written smoothly and some not. So that's also fate and destiny. When will we have inspirations? Hard to predict. Let the blessings and protections by Golden Mother and Buddhas and Bodhisattvas be on me, so that in my book writing and painting, I would have inspiration every day. I ask this because this is my career in delivering sentient beings. At the beginning of the question and answer, let me share a joke first. The first time I heard it, someone cut it for me. The bed is messy. It's more creative than people who have tidy bed. Like in the morning, when we get up, we have to make our bed. But if you don't make up your bed, you don't make your bed, then your creativity is 50 times more. If you always forget your things here and there, you're not as ambitious. And people who have big appetite has 90% more EQ compared to the people with small appetite. People who love to slip in are more empathetic than people who are in a routine. People who often are late has more sense of humor, 70%. Without knowing, I discovered that I am such a excellent. You know, let me tell you that I am the opposite of these people. I have to make my bed every day, so I have no creativity. I always place everything in an orderly fashion. Even when I place this piece of paper, it would be exactly straight. It would not be disorderly. Everything is orderly. That's why I love fame and privileges. My appetite. Recently, doctors told me to eat very little, cannot eat too much. That you will have some health problems. But it said here, if you have big appetite compared to people with small appetite, has 90% more EQ. I don't like to sleep. I would wake up when I'm supposed to wake up, and I would sleep whenever I'm supposed to sleep. I have a normal routine. I will write an article every day. I will practice every day. I will paint a painting every day. I'm once with the disciplined routine, so therefore I have no empathy. I'm rather not late. But why I'm always late when I drive here? Because I have to bring someone. I am never late. When I had a date before, I would be 15 minutes early. Always, never late. So, my sense of humor is lost. I found out that I turned out to be so dumb. So, is this accurate? No. You know who gave me this joke? Master Hui Jun. The first question asked by Taiwan Lianhua Guozai. On August 27th, 2000, in Hong Kong, Grandmaster conducted the Kalachakra Grand Ceremony. And during the ceremony, you transmitted the Pyramid Mudra of the Jambhala Buddha land or country and the mantra Om Ah Hom Brum Ah Brum. So we have the mudra and mantra of the Jambhala country. Could we have the opportunity to learn how to visualize the Jambhala country? Check the internet. Is there an image or drawing of the Jambhala country? I have seen it in one of the sutras, the map of the Jambhala country. Anyone has seen it? Anyone have seen the map of Jambhala? Jambhala Buddha country? And is it in the internet? I remember I've seen it before.
Om Ah Hom Brum Ah Brum.
That's the mantra. Did you see it? Did you find it, Master Lian Yan? Really, they have the Jambhala map. Jambhala country map. So, yeah, this is what I saw. The kingdom of Jambhala. So, how do you visualize? You visualize the map of the Jambhala. This is the map of the Jambhala kingdom. Because I have seen the map of the Jambhala kingdom. Is it in the cell phones? So you visualize the geography and the map of Jambhala in your brain, and then with the mudra, the pyramid mudra and the mantra. That's the mantra. We know about Om Ahom and Brum, which is what we usually chant, Om Brim, Om Brim, Om Brim. Actually, it is Brum.
Om Brim is Phu Phang Sangshi taught me. Phu Phang Sangshi told me Om Brim.
So Master Phu Phang told me about Om Brim. But based on what I know, it should be Om Brum.
Nung,
Kun Lin. So that's why the teaching of different gurus are different. That's the real pronunciation and the mantra and mudra. And then you visualize the map of the Jambhala kingdom. The second question by Malaysia, Lian Hua Ge Yan. Homage to the precious Grandmaster. Your disciple, Lian Hua Ge Yan, have practiced the four preliminary practices for over 20 years, yet I have not gained any spiritual response. I have completed 8 million times of Root Guru mantra recitation. Can I start practicing Root Guru yoga? Please provide your guidance. This question has been asked. Last Sunday, didn't we talk about this? How come it's here again? Yes, you can. Yes, you can practice the Root Guru Yoga. Because you have completed 8 million times of Root Guru Mantra. So there must be the power of the blessing. So who knows, maybe you would gain spiritual response after you start practicing it. Everything is predestined. Some people never gain spiritual union even until they're really old. Some old monks have practiced all their lives and they don't have any spiritual responses. Like Grandmaster, I just went to the Jade Emperor Temple. As soon as I kneeled, and Golden Mother immediately was in spiritual union with me. What should we say? I never practiced. I did not even know Golden Mother then. I don't even know any gods. I was still a Christian then. from the Presbyterian. I have no knowledge of the Taoism and Buddhism, but someone's been practicing for so long and has no spiritual response. So the cloth puppet is still playing. So even if you hate your own fate, you cannot be resentful or complain to the heavens. You just that's really my faith. There's a joke related to faith. This is a joke. I went to fortune teller to check if I have money or not in this life. And the fortune teller wrote in the piece of the paper and wrote, your character and your destiny. Which of these two is more important? But this destiny also means life. And then I said, of course, life is more important. And the fortune teller said, then you will not have money. And he asked, why? The fortune teller said, if you have money, then you would follow your desire. But if you have no money, then you would admit your destiny. Wealthy people are more following their desire, more headstrong or willful. And this disciple did not have any spiritual response after practicing 20 years. But Grandmaster Lu got it as soon as I kneeled down. So that was the destiny of a dog's poo. What can I say? It just happened. I did not practice. Nothing. I just kneeled. And Golden Mother already descended. So, Amitabha Buddha too descended. Siddhikarva Bodhisattva. So, that's my destiny. So no spiritual response after over 20 years, Amitabha. The third question. Lianhua Dawei from Taiwan. Upon receiving an empowerment for smoke offering, I have practiced it 500 times. At about over 400 times, all of a sudden, a crow appeared, and it's crowing very sad and shrill. At first, I thought it was a coincidence. Little did I knew. Afterwards, every time I performed the smoke offering, the crow would be there and crowing ever so sadly. And when I didn't do the smoke offering, the crow was not there. It's really amazing. I tested it several times. Every time when I visualize making offering, then the crow shrill the worst. My impression is that crow is not a good omen. Every time it appeared there, I've, there's an eerie feeling in me. Please advise why this is. What should I do? What does the crow represent? I just know that all living beings have souls, but I'm not sure if it is good or bad. Thank you, Grandmaster. Lianhua Dawei from Taiwan. So when he practiced smoke offering for 400 times, every time he practiced it, the crow would shrill. And if he doesn't practice, the crow doesn't shrill. So that's his response. But the shrill is very sad. This is also strange. Let me consult. So, the guidance from the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas are because when you practice smoke offering, that's for your karmic creditors. So, all of your karmic creditors gathered at that crow, on that crow, and shrill very sadly. That meant that your karmic creditors are still suffering. So your smoke offering cannot extinguish the suffering of your karmic creditors. The guidance of the Golden Mother is, since you know that your karmic creditors are suffering, then you help them by bardo delivering them, bardo deliverance for them. Register them for bardo deliverance, Homa offering several times. Until the crow does not appear anymore, which means until your smoke offering is extremely good. But this is also a kind of spiritual response, because when you perform the smoke offering, your karmic creditors gathered at that crow to signify their suffering. So you have to find ways to bardo deliver them. Until one day, the crow appears but does not shrill very sadly anymore, which means you have succeeded in your smoke offering. That's the answer given by the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. So the appearance of birds in the sky happened to Grandmaster many times. The first time I transmitted Akalanata was in California at the San Francisco. area, the first time I transmitted Akaladatta. When I transmitted the Buddha Dharma, all the birds in the sky descended. And they chirped together. People who attended, De Hua, the Venerable Lily, many birds descended and chirped together. And at the Rainbow Temple, Rainbow Villa, when we consecrate the Maitreya Bodhisattva, that's in white, when I was consecrating him, there were rays of sunlight, and then all the birds descended together and make songs and sang together. Anyone there then? Many people knew. The Venerable Lily, Biyan, many. That they all raise their hands. Also, when the Tribuda Seattle chapter was consecrated in Chinatown, all the birds also descended and then perched on the electricity cable in a line. Many people saw that on the the power cable, all lined up there. And also at the Freedom Square in Taipei, or the CKS Memorial Hall. You know, when I was conducting the Mahotara Heruka Grand Ceremony, we had the pagoda there, right? The mandala, and then all the birds descended and then circled around it. That's also quite miraculous. Many people saw that. Many people took pictures and videos. Mahotara Heruka. This kind of phenomena happened. And the day when I was about to get married, I was walking here and I saw on top of the Tribuda Tantric Quarter, there are two magpies jumping and jumping over there. And I thought, oh wow, there's the magpie there. And I'm about to get married. And sure enough, that evening, there was a lady that brought her suitcase wanting to come to stay my home and get married to Grandmaster. Right? Did it happen? Yes. And she's very slim, has good figure. Unfortunately, Simu did not agree. And finally, she left, carrying her suitcase and never returned again. So if Simu agreed, if Simu had agreed, then she would have become the first wife. So wife becomes the first wife. That lady really carried her luggage here. Many people knew. Many omen.
Malaysia 莲花家人问,
from Malaysia, Lianhua Jiaren. I have taken refuge in Grandmaster for 20 years, but my daily practice of the Vajrasattva's four preliminary practices started about 4 years ago. My question is, why is it that I haven't been able to change my bad temper? It came suddenly, and afterwards it is all fine. Of course, after it passes, then it's fine. Otherwise, that would have been horrible. But people around me cannot stand it. I feel disturbed by it too, but I just cannot control it. How should I change my bad temper? Thank you very much for your teaching. Wish you good health and peace. Let me tell you. Under the heavens, the one with the worst temper is my grandfather. My grandfather has a horrible temper. When he is reprimanding kids, based on what I know, because when I was born, he's already passed away. But his temper was really bad. So bad that his one daughter went to school in Japan, and she was doing something, and then she was sewing something, and he grabbed her hair and pushed her head to that sewing machine until it was bleeding. I heard that my grandfather was really horrible, and he used his hands really badly. And then my dad inherited that bad temper. His temper was also terrifying. You know, the wooden bat is very solid and huge, and he would take off my shirt, and he would just beat me until the bat was broken. So I grew up in an abusive family, and then I got I inherited it. My temper was also very vicious. In the past, my temper was very violent. I wasn't afraid of my dad. Of course, he's my elder, so I just endured it when he beat me. But when I get angry, when I got angry, I wouldn't care about anything. I would even break down the wall, the door, the windows. When I got really angry, I would also become physical. I would hit something. Simu knew when I was young, I also had a bad temper. But after becoming a Buddhist, studying Buddhism, I changed. After practicing Buddhism, I changed. I trained in endurance. Actually, I was very vicious, very ferocious. Nobody knew. When I get angry, when I became ferocious, I'm extremely violently ferocious. But now I just endure it and become patient and endure it. In the past, I bullied Simu. Now Simu bully me. Simu bullies me. When Simu gets angry, immediately I would run away. I would keep my distance. This is a method. We cannot lose the temper at the same time. So if she raised her voice, then I would go away further. Because when I hear loud voices, then I would be even louder. So the only thing I can do is to keep my distance and go away further. Don't listen to it and then endure myself. And sometimes, before, from time to time, I would also raise my voice, but now I don't. And I never use my hands. Gentlemen never raise their hands toward a woman. Because once you do that, that's the end of you. Never, never hit your anyone. Then that would cause a wound that was never, that could never heal. In the past, I did use my hands, and that's never erased. Now other people use their hands or raise voices. Now all I could do is just to endure it. Doesn't matter how loud that person speaks, I cannot raise my voice. All I can do is just to go away. So people around me cannot stand it, which is true. You should not have a temper normally. Ordinarily, you shouldn't have any temper. As a spiritual cultivator, we have to tame our own temper. And only when you have an even-keeled mind that you can harmonize your qi. And your name is very good. Lianhua Jiaren. So you have to add compassion and benevolence. So your name is already reminding you, teaching you all the time. You should be patient, endurance. You have to have compassion. You should not let other people suffer because of you. And your wife, when your wife become vicious, then you just go way further away. And because you didn't hear it, then you're not affected. And it's okay, just let it go. So you yourself should not lose your temper, because your name is Jiaren. So please remember, never lose your own temper. It's okay that your wife loses her temper. All you can do is just to avoid it and just to go further away. Keep a distance. Grandmaster, how can I change my bad temper? What should I do when I lose my temper? You should remember what Grandmaster is teaching you. Or else you go back to your own bed and then you use your fists to beat your blankets. To let go of your anger. then once the anger subsides, then you'll be fine. Just keep a distance. This is endurance. Is there any other way? I'd like to ask everyone, any other way? I also have bad temper. In the past, I was also short-tempered. And after spiritual cultivation, I changed. From Taiwan, homage the precious Dharma King. In 1999, Dharma ceremony of Guru Padmasambhava, Supreme Dharma, for purifications, enrichment, magnetization, and subjugation, presided by Master Lianhua Chengzu. I have the following questions on the meaning of these two praises in the sadhana. Om Ahum, I take refuge in the supreme teachings and regard them as the parents of the sentient beings in the six rebirth realms. To be liberated from rebirth, to attain Buddhahood, we together profess the Bodhisattva, the Bodhicitta vow. And Om Ahom, assimilating all the Dharma for rebirth and Nirvana, from the origin of empty extinction like an open sky, to abandon any attachments, getting, giving, and contriving, as spoken by I, Guru Padmasambhava. Let me explain. Om Ahom is the beginning of the mantra that we chant. Om is the universe, Ah is the Yidam, Hom is the perfection. Om Ahom means the perfect universe. I take refuge in the most supreme teachings. I take refuge in the most supreme teachings and regard them as the parents of the sentient beings in the six rebirth realms, because you have many parents from many lifetimes. You want to help and deliver parents from many lifetimes. And where are they? They are amidst the six rebirth realms: heavenly realm, human realm, asura, hell, animal, and holy ghost realms. The parents from your past lives are all there. They all have parents from your past lives. To be liberated from rebirth, to attain Buddhahood. We don't want to be reborn again. We want to attain Buddhahood. You and the parents in the six rebirth realms together profess the supreme Bodhicitta. That's the explanation of this praise, this verse. We together profess the Bodhicitta vow, which means you take refuge in front of the most supreme teachings in order to liberate the parents that are in the six rebirth realms, so that we don't need to be reborn again, and together attaining Buddhahood. And we profess the mind to liberate sentient beings. That's the meaning of the first vow, the first praise. The second praise, Om Ahom, the same. The consciousness of the universe is perfect, assimilating all the Dharma for rebirth and Nirvana. The Supreme Buddha Dharma includes the Dharma for rebirth and for extinction, or the path, the Buddha Buddhist path, Dharma for rebirth and for Nirvana, extinction, all included. From the origin of empty extinction like an open sky. Originally, there were no mountains and oceans and none of the phenomena. The whole universe is empty and extinct, just like the open sky. And all the phenomena, the earth, mountains and oceans, were manifested from the sky, from the emptiness. One is emptiness, one is existence. To abandon any attachments and getting, giving and contriving and two sides. We avoid the two sides. We not attach to emptiness nor existence. The dual execution of emptiness and existence is the middle way, the Madhyamaka. We don't side to any sides, not to the emptiness, not to the existence. So, and both of them together to become the middle way. And the development stage and perfection stage are executed in duality. And existence and emptiness together, and then bliss and wisdom are executed together. The Buddha Dharma is the Madhyamaka. And I, Guru Padmasambhava, said so or spoken by Guru Padmasambhava. So what is dual execution? Dual execution of rebirth and nirvana, of emptiness and existence, of bliss and emptiness. That's the concept of Madhyamaka, or the middle way. Therefore, no birth, no death. Therefore, away from attachments, from getting, from giving, or releasing. You cannot get anything, and you cannot release anything. No gain and no loss. Away from the two extremes, and away from any contriving, and away from the two extremes, as spoken by Guru Padmasambhava. That's the explanation. Do you understand or not? The next question. I have two questions about water offering. For the water offering tower, do we need to set up dry ice or mist so that it looks like the fairyland of Golden Mother? Or is it okay, we just use that water tower by itself? This is a question about the practice procedure. Typically speaking, when you perform water offering, you need a mist or dry ice to create mist, to give you a kind of feeling, so that people have some feeling. You cannot just put the water in a triangular tower. It's not a wish pond. So you want to create inspiration or feeling to make it feel mystical and holy. It's okay to create that. For the fire offering, we can write our wish on a Homa card and throw it into the Homa fire. As for the water offering, can I write my wish on a small piece of paper and throw it into the water? My wish? It's okay. If you just write a small piece of paper with wishes, and then put it into the water offering tower, it's okay. Now I will read the next from Lamdre. The fourth kind, the meditation arising from the cause. The fifth one, a brief explanation on the meditation arising from the cause is as follows. The verse, the mind abides internally by relying on the other. The meaning of the mind abiding internally is to absorb the mind like a bee is glued to the glue. The verse, absorbing the five consciousness. Like the moment of absorbing the mind, the eyes and the other senses are not affected by the environments. This is the dispositional nature of meditation. Let me talk about these two paragraphs first. The verse, the mind abides internally by relying on the other. The meaning of the mind abides internally is to absorb the mind like the bee glued to the glue. Our mind is like galloping horses and moving monkeys. So your mind is like jumping monkeys and your thoughts are like galloping horses. But what is the mind abides internally? That's to absorb the mind, to bind the mind and glue and bind the mind there. It's like the rein that bind the horse. And analogy is like a bee that's flying, flying. So, a bee is also flying non-stop, keep moving. But if you use a 3-second glue, and then when the bee is touching it, then it would be glued and cannot move anymore. This is called absorbing the mind. When you catch the bee and to make it stop, and when you catch your mind and to make it stop, that's the mind abides internally, and also called the mind absorption. To make the bee or the monkey or the horse not moving, that's called the mind absorption. You want to make your mind not moving, that's mind abiding. That's what it means here. You have to learn meditation. In order for you to learn meditation, you have to have mind absorption. You don't want to think of any other things. You have to bring it back. And we call that what do you call that? Oh, I forget the word. It's called stopping and seeing. And there's major stopping and seeing and minor stopping and seeing. Stop. So you stop all of your thoughts and seeing, which is visualization. You're being mindful. And not only this, there's a profound meaning to the stopping and seeing. In the seeing, you focus all your thoughts onto one thought. First, you use this method. You make all of your thoughts to focus on one thought, and then you stop it. You stop your thoughts completely. That's mind absorption, which is mind abiding internally. Second, the verse absorbing the five consciousness, which is the five consciousness are of the eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and body. Is that right? That's form, sights, sound, taste, smell, and touch. So that's why the arhats have to kill the six thieves, and the thieves are the six senses of the eyes, ear, nose, tongue, body, and mind. Why do you want to kill the six thieves? Because when you see, then you would think of that, one of what you see. That's why you want to close your eyes. When you hear a sound, you know, then you are distracted by the sound. So that's why you have to close your ears or your hearing sense. Or if you smell fragrance or a stinky smell, you want to close your nose too. Or the taste, that's why you want to close your tongue too. Or when your body touches something, then you have a certain sensation from that. So that's why you want to shut off the touching sense. All the senses of the eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and body, and the mind, and also the taste, the sights, the sound, smell, touch. Absorbing the five consciousness, like the moment of absorbing the mind, the eyes, and the other senses, so that they are not affected by the environments. This is the disposable nature of meditation. When you close off all the sense organs and then the sensation, then you will not be affected by those. So if you open your eyes, then whatever you see, your thoughts will follow that and would make up a long story about it. That's why they say the eyes look at the nose and the nose look gaze at the mind. The eyes gaze at the nose gaze at the mind to become one. And from one to become zero, and that is meditation. When one becomes zero, that becomes meditation. First, the eyes gaze at the nose gazes at the mind. Then you enter into one. Then from one, you enter into zero, and that is meditation. So this is the dispositional nature of meditation. You have to absorb the five consciousness, the five senses, and you have to resolve all these five senses. Now you understand, that's all. For now. There's a plane that got off for 30 seconds and then got back down, landed again. And then waited for 20 minutes and then took off again. And at the standard elevation, a curious passenger asked the stewardess, "So what happened earlier?" And the stewardess replied, "Because when the first time they took off, they realized there was a strange noise on the left, so he did not want to continue and landed. And the passenger was content and said, 'Oh, so you fixed the engine?' And the student said, no, no, we just found a different pilot that dared to fly it, regardless. That's a joke. There's a drunken, nude man, and then was trying to wave a taxi in the deep of the night. And the driver was a woman, and her eyes glared at this nude man, and this nude man felt embarrassed being glared. You never saw a naked man before? And the driver replied, I wasn't looking at your body. I was just checking. Where would you get the money from? That's right. You're naked. So where would the money be? You wanted to get on my taxi, but how would you pay? Where do you keep your money? That makes sense. I feel often we are being cheated by the eyes. Men are often tricked by their eyes. Why? How can your eyes trick you? Of course, the eyes can trick you and cheat it on you. You know, makeup, you know, the makeup tricks are extremely incredible now. The eyebrows that's upside down becomes nicely curved, and eyes with no soul at all would become radiant. And the nose that turn up can be made up that they look very different. So after makeup, she became beautiful. And when you see that, you would be dumbfounded. But when she took off her makeup, oh my God, it's a grandma. Becomes your grandma. So that's why you're being cheated, right? By your eyes. Don't you think so? White hair, all have hair. And now her hair is black after being dyed. And you thought, oh wow, that, what the beautiful hair, and there's some nice smell that kind of brush through your face, and you feel very content. And then one day, she did not dye her hair, and you happened to see it, and it turned out it's half, still half white. Still a grandma. So you're being tricked by your eyes. We are often being tricked by our own eyes, our ears, by our own nose, our own mouth, our own body. So in order to meditate, we have to close off this five senses of the eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and body, of the sight, sound, smell, taste, and touch. They all have to be closed off. That's the important reason why we are able to enter into meditation. We are very grateful to His Holiness Precious Dharma Teaching. Tomorrow, Sunday at 3 p.m., August 16, we are inviting His Holiness to preside over the Green Tara Homa Fire Offering Ceremony at the Rainbow Temple in North Bend, Washington. And on September 13, I believe, the Sunday at 11 a.m., His Holiness will be at the Rainbow Temple to perform the ritual, the Seng Ji ritual, which is the ritual for the Life Foundation. Now we are inviting His Holiness to consecrate the Buddha images. This ends the English interpretation today. Thank you very much.
Om 三拜诸护法金刚 Om Ah Hum 四平等一起所 同修会圆满吉祥结束的非常感恩根本传承上师的大家时感谢师母诸位上师教授师法师以及网络直播现场观看的各级弘法人员的护持谢谢大家阿弥陀佛网络直播到此结束非常感谢大家的收看。We now conclude this live broadcast. Thank you for viewing. 我们现在恭请法王圣尊莲生活佛以福尘加持与会众弟子